Hi guys, my name is Ray. You're welcome to this Facebook page if you're watching on Facebook, or you're welcome to my YouTube channel if you're watching on YouTube. Thank you for clicking on this video. So today we're going to talk about fake makeup, or you can even call it fake up, and in particular we are going to talk about fake lipsticks. So before we begin, so if you've not yet subscribed to my channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button and also hit the notification bell so that every time I upload a video, you get notified and don't miss out on any of my content. And if you're watching on Facebook, make sure you hit the like button and also make sure you follow this page so that every time I upload, you get notified. So let's talk about fake lipsticks. I'm going to start by generalizing majority people. More specifically, us Ugandans wear fake lipsticks, and it's what is available on the markets. Like if you go downtown, majority shops in town, I'm sorry to say, but they all sell fake products in general. So we are going to start by identifying, how do you know that this is a fake lipstick and how do you know that this is a genuine lipstick? So I'm going to give you a few points of how you can tell a fake lipstick from a genuine lipstick, or a fake product from a genuine product. So point number one is, fake lipsticks are not packaged in a box. So normally when you buy a genuine lipstick or any makeup product, it comes packaged in a box, something like this. It should come in a box. But when you buy a lipstick, either from downtown especially, I mean, they'll just hand it to you or put it in like a small polythene bag. Normally it is a fake product. Point number two, it's the obvious thing, which is the price point. If you're buying a lipstick of like 2,000, 5,000, 10,000, 20,000, most of those lipsticks are not genuine, because it takes a lot to create a genuine product. So naturally it has to be a little bit priced a little bit higher than you'd normally want to spend, because I know most people want to just get like 5,000, buy a lipstick, call it a day. So that is point number two, and the price point. Point number three, lipsticks that are fake are very, very difficult to apply, and they're also very, very difficult to remove. When you apply it on your lips, it cracks, it sticks. So I'm just going to show you like a little demonstration. So I have a lipstick right here. This is, if you read, it says like it's a Kylie lipstick. It's like number 9. So when you look at this lipstick, you're most likely to think this is like a nice, genuine lipstick. I bought this thinking this is a nice, genuine lipstick. I was thinking, oh my god, I have a Kylie lipstick. You know, I can do an ombre lip. It has like a pink color. You know, I love pink. If I swatch it right here, so I was quite excited. But let me show you how this lipstick works and you just judge for yourself. So this is my lipstick and I'm applying it. I'm just going to apply it on the top of this lipstick that I'm wearing. So I first gave this a few minutes to let it really crack very well. As you can see, if I smile, it's like really, really cracked. It's not even, it's not balanced. So that's how you tell this is really a very, very poor quality lipstick. So I'm sure you've all come across such a lipstick. Just know that's a fake lipstick, as simple. I'm going to take this off and come back with my normal lipstick that I was wearing, because I prefer that. So I've taken off the fake lipstick that was on top and I'm just wearing my normal lipstick that I had on earlier. So the easiest way to take off this fake lipstick is to apply an oil or a Vaseline on your lips, and then after, you just wipe it off with a makeup wipe or anything else that you're using. So another way to identify fake lipsticks is to read the name correctly. Sometimes when they are doing these lipsticks, they actually spell the names wrong. For example, if they're trying to imitate like a Kylie or a Huda Beauty, they'll just write it, but then write it so wrongly. Because in most cases, fake lipsticks, they just try to do like a counterfeit for the original product, because they know this product is already popular. Kylie Jenner is popular, Huda Beauty is popular, so just try to make like a fake version, you know, because they know that people out there who don't have a lot of money, it's us Ugandans, third world countries, we can just push this product there, because, you know, so you can just also watch out for that as another way to identify these fake products. So I'm going to insert a clip of a video that I came across on YouTube showing how they actually manufacture fake lipsticks. I looked at it and I was like, wow, is this what actually happens? You know, they looked at like the lipsticks that they actually do sell downtown. It just didn't look a professional place, like a laboratory, you know, where they can test ingredients and test this and test that. It looks really, really, really random.
আচ্ছা দেখো এটা
এটা এই সময় খুলে
মানে এটা কি বানালেন
লিপস্টিক
কি লিপস্টিক
তাহলে Lakme 92
Lakme
925
জি এটা মডেলের নাম্বার নাকি জি দেখি জিনিসটা কি হলো এরপর কি করবেন এখন এটা থেকে এটা কি করবেন এরপর ইয়াতে ফ্রিজে রাখবেন নাকি
জি ভাই এটা
একটু দেখি কি দেখি রাখেন এরপর ফ্রিজে রাখলে কি হবে এটা
ঠান্ডা হবে
ভিডিওগুলো ঘরে ঘরে আপনাদের বন্ধুদের কাছে পৌঁছে দিতে
হবে
তাও লাভ হবে না না
ওরা বলবে না এটা দুই নম্বর দেখুন ভালোটা আছে ইন্ডিয়ান
আমি কিনি ভালোটা
হ্যাঁ ইন্ডিয়ানটা কিনি আমি
এটা দিটা
কিনি
দেখি একটা আমাকে শুনেন তো
কমপ্লিট
উফ
ভেঙে গেল তো পুরোটা ও আচ্ছা পুরোটা বের করাতে বুঝছি 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 যাই হোক ঠিক আছে আচ্ছা এগুলো বিক্রি করেন কার কাছে মানে কারা যায় এই
So I'm also going to talk about why should you buy nice lipsticks or original lipsticks anyway. A one fake lipsticks or fake products in general, can even call it fake up. It can cause allergic reactions. You can easily get rash. You can get swellings on your lip. You can get, you can even get burnt by some of the chemicals in these products. You can get pimples. I mean, you can get all sorts of reactions by your body because they do not include, they do not put genuine ingredients in this product. That's why you can easily get, you know, all sorts of irritations. And also you realize that most of the people, when they're eating, they actually do swallow this product. They're taking their tea, eating their food, and then the lipstick is all over the cup and then they are swallowing it. So it's just like a precaution, you know, or a safety measure. If you're swallowing these things, like what are you swallowing, you know, like what are you eating? And these are products that are, you know, you don't even know what's included. You can't Google the ingredients and find them. So it's just a good way of just being like very, you know, careful. Whatever we are consuming and applying on our body, it should be at least authentic, you know. I'm going to talk about where you can find a nice original products around Kampala. So let's first talk about the brands that you can easily buy, nice brands, because if you can't identify, if you can't look at a product and identify its brand, it means this product is most likely to be fake. So when you're looking for products to buy, you can look out for, I'm going to first recommend a drugstore products. Drugstore means that the product is original, but it's quite affordable. So I can talk about Maybelline, that's a drugstore brand. We could talk about a Colourpop, a Revlon, Milani, that's quite popular around town, Black Opal, that's also very popular. Those are drugstore brands, so you know if you're buying any of their products, it's most likely to be quite affordable and also original. And then the places where you can actually get these products, so these products also have their counterfeits, you know, which you can also get around town. So the places where you're going to get these products in original, you can go to Beauty Corner. I believe Beauty Corner sells good quality products, makeup products. I think they have Milani, they have Black Opal that is original. You can go to, there is a MAC store at Acacia Mall. I mean, it's MAC, so they have, they are selling real MAC products that are original. But that's quite high end if you have quite a good amount of money to spend. There is also, next to MAC, I believe there is another store which I really don't remember its name. But it's quite an attractive shop when you enter. They have Black Opal products. I think they also have Revlon. And these products, their prices range like from 80,000, maybe like for a foundation. It's just around that, maybe like between 80 or between 70 and 100,000. Someone would be like, oh, that's high. How can I pay 80,000 for a lipstick or 80,000 for a foundation? Well, this is what I would say. I believe majority of us love to look good. You could get like 100,000, 200,000, invest in your hair, buy a nice piece, you know, look good, or buy anything nice for yourself. So why not get that same amount of money and buy a nice product? Remember, this is a product you're going to use on your skin. You're applying it on your lips, you're applying it on your face, you're applying it on your eyes. So why not buy a nice lipstick? I really, really want to discourage this when people just say, oh, I can't buy a lipstick of 50,000, you know, I just want to spend 2,000 or 5,000. Like, why would you do that? Yet you can actually use the same amount of money to spend on other things, you know. So I think it's really, really important to have at least have one or two nice products than have like 10 lipsticks that are fake. Just have one, you know, it's enough. And when you wear a genuine product, actually people will recognize, you know, people will notice it. Your friends will compliment you, be like, oh my god, which lipstick are you wearing? Oh my god, what foundation is that? Oh my god, like, you easily notice a genuine product, even just by the way it looks. It looks better than a fake product. You can tell when people do their makeup. If you ever go downtown, I've seen those places where they do makeup of like 10,000, 15,000. Trust me, that makeup always looks so bad. You know, you can just look at it and tell that this doesn't look good. And whereas if you look at your top makeup artists in Kampala, some of your favorite makeup artists, go to their pages, look at their work looks good. Why? Because they use nice products, you know? And that's why they are quite pricing their service quite high, because they've invested in a lot of money. They understand what it means to do good makeup. So they try to have the right products. And that's why their work is good. That's why they charge a lot. So I also think it's really important, of course, to look good. Yes, definitely. So if you want to look good, then you have to put in some money. So I really encourage you that just have one good product. You know, buy one good product per month, you know. You don't have to buy like everything at once. Definitely, it's quite a lot. So just get one good product per month. You know, you could do that once in 2 months. Get a good lipstick, you know, get a good powder, get a good foundation. And those things will actually make a difference for you, and you'll actually get to appreciate using nice makeup products. In conclusion, if you want, you could also learn more about these brands which manufacture good products. Instagram is a very good place to go to. You can just type in MAC or Maybelline or Colourpop just to educate yourself about these nice products. You can type in, normally these are huge brands, so they have a blue tick, verified by Instagram. That is like the easiest way to tell this is a good brand. You can see that they are posting these products, they're posting these looks. If you go to their website, you can read about what ingredients they use, what they actually put in their products. You can also read reviews from other people who have used the product. Do they like it? Do they not like it? And this is not only for makeup, it's actually for anything else that you would be buying, you know. Anything else that you should be buying, it's always good to first read about it before you actually buy it. So I had forgotten another place where you can actually buy good makeup. There is a lady in Krishnamart. Krishnamart is a mall in Kisementi. She's maybe on the third or fourth floor. Her shop is called Urban Glow. She also has good makeup products. I've bought from her a few times. There is another shop still around the same Kisementi area. If you get any makeup shops around that place, they are most likely to have nice genuine products, you know. So if you're looking for genuine products to buy around Kampala, you might not get a variety, but at least you'll be able to get a foundation, you'll be able to get a powder, and you'll be able to get a lipstick, because those are the basics, and I believe majority of us have those things. They have a lipstick, they have a foundation, they have a powder, like those are the basics of a makeup look. So at least you should be able to get some of those products. So in conclusion, I mean, just stay away from fake makeup, fake lipstick, fake anything, you know, just stay away from it. I just discourage it really a lot. Just stay away from it. And if you've liked this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, make sure you like it. If you're watching on YouTube, make sure you subscribe to my channel and also hit the notification bell so that every time I upload a video, you get notified so that you don't miss out on any of my content, and that will also help my channel to grow. If you're watching on Facebook, make sure you like the page, Lit Faces, and also make sure that you give it a follow so that every time I upload a video or post anything, then you can get notified in your newsfeed. So make sure you leave a comment, share your thoughts with me, and in case you have any questions, I'm okay to share whatever I know and advise. And thank you for watching. I'll see you on my next video. Bye.